Hi guys, in this video I'll discuss how to prepare prosody and rhetoric part for PAPDET exam or any other college entrance test for BA English honors. Now, if you look at the previous year's question paper, then you'll understand that a minimum 3 or maximum 5 questions have been asked from this part. It means that questions of maximum 10 marks have been asked from this part itself. So it's important that you cover this part, and it's not, you know, it doesn't require you to make so much of study, you know. If you, even if you do a basic level preparation from this part, then you'll be able to answer questions, at least 2 or 3 questions. Okay. So it's not a big deal. First, I'll take the previous year's question paper, the types of questions, what kinds of questions were asked in 2017, in 18 and 19. Then I'll take, you know, prosody part, how to prepare in detail, and then rhetoric part. Okay. So let's get started. Now, in 2017, the first question was asked from this part, what is the study of poetry, rhythm and music? It's from prosody. So it's the definition of prosody itself. Okay. So the study of, you know, rhythm, music, poetry, rhythm, music is called prosody. And there are options, 4 options. Out of those 4 options, so there was one option, prosody. So you have to answer that questions. Okay. And in 2019, you can see here in the below that question of what is the scansion was asked. You know, it's a very basic question that you need to know while studying the prosody part. Okay. So it's a basic level that you need to start off with. The second question was that a poem written in undimed iambic pentameter has, now there was option, 4 options. So it's the definition of blank verse. So like I previously discussed in PAPDET preparation that you need to prepare this blank verse, free verse. Okay. So it is a question of blank verse. Now I'm not discussing in detail. I'm just showing you here the kinds of questions that were asked in 2017, 18 and 19. Then when I'll discuss in the next slide about prosody, then I'll, you know, discuss in detail. The third question is identify the figure of speech. So it's from rhetoric part. So there is the 2 lines from a poem and it's a metaphor. Okay. So it's from metaphor. So there are very common, very popular rhetoric or figure of speech. If you study those on a basic level, then you'll be able to answer questions. Okay. Like metaphor, simile, you'll have this question from this part. Now the fourth question was asked. So in 2017, there was 5 questions total. I have just put here 4th question. There's also another question I didn't write here. Okay. So like I said, maximum 5 questions, you can expect it and you can get it right, you know, out of 5 and 5. Okay. So the figure of speech employed in the sentence, England lost by 6 wickets. So it's from rhetoric part. So it's a snake donkey. I didn't write the options because it will be long. So I just wrote the questions here. In 2018, so it's from rhetoric part. There is this 2 phrases from a poem, the monstrous anger of the guns squares if wailing's shell. So it's from it's a personification that we have studied already in our school. Identify the figure of speech in the phrase those who die as cattle. So it's from simile, rhetoric part. Now this part is also from rhetoric. India won the test match against Sri Lanka. This question, England lost by 6 wickets, and this question is the same. It's a snake donkey rhetoric. Okay. In 2017, this questions was asked like the same questions from snake donkey. The registration fee for the seminar has been fixed at 500 per head. Par head is the figure of speech, so it's from snake donkey again. So it's not a metonymy. So metonymy snake donkey is similar, but there is some nuances you need to understand. There is some very little difference. Okay. Slight difference that you need to figure out. So it's like the simile metaphor. It's pretty much same, but there is a trick you can understand from looking at the sentence itself. Okay. So you can see that all these questions, these 2019 questions, these 2018 question, then this 2017 question, these are same kind of questions. Okay. So, and it's from snake donkey rhetoric. Okay. So you can understand from these types of questions that how you need to prepare this part. Okay. Third question, like I mentioned at the start, that the definition of scansion was asked. So it's a very basic thing that you need to understand what is scansion, what is prosody, what is rhetoric, and the definition of these terms itself. Okay. Now the third question was in which kind of verse is Milton's Paradise Lost written? So it's a very like quiz like question. So it's, if you study blank verse, then you'll have this question that Milton's Paradise Lost was written in blank verse. So there are some popular, you know, poems that were written in blank verse. So like Milton's Paradise Lost. Okay. So Tennyson's One of the Poems was written in blank verse. So there are some popular poem, then you will understand while studying this blank verse part. Okay. The fourth question was, how many iambic feet are there in the verse known as Alexandrine? So these last three questions from 2019 are from prosody part. Okay. So you may expect, you know, three questions from prosody, two questions from rhetoric, or it could be the other way around. Okay. So it depends. Like in 2018, most of the questions were from a rhetoric part. Okay. So you need to do it simultaneously, this prosody and rhetoric part. Now I'll move to the prosody part, how to start with the prosody. Like for the beginner, those who haven't studied this part prosody in a school, it will be tough for them how to start with this part. Okay, it's a branch of study in English literature they need to do. So for the beginners, I hope I'll be able to give some hints or some advices so that you can start your own preparation. So prosody, first you need to understand the meter and metrical patterns. Okay, so there is these two things. One is that rhyme and the another thing is the rhythm. Okay, the rhyme we all know, jachi khachi ei rokom je mil ekdom shobde sese sese. To rhyme e onek bhag ache, ami ogulo pore slide e bolchi. So this rhythm is different. So in order to understand rhythm of a poem, you first need to understand the meter. And if you look at the meter, then you'll have this foot or feet. Feet is the plural form and foot is the singular form. If you look at the feet or foot of a poem, then you'll understand the syllable. Okay, so syllable, foot and meter. These all constitutes a poem's rhythm. Okay, so a poem might not contain rhyme, but it may be in rhythm. Okay, so rhythm, rhyme na thekeo ekta poem er rhythm thakte pare. সেটার জন্য যদি মিটার আমরা আইডেন্টিফাই করতে পারি বা মিটার যে স্ক্যানসন যদি আমরা করতে পারি, এগুলো যে অ্যানালাইজ করতে পারি, দেন উইল আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্য রিদম কিভাবে আছে। তো এগুলো সাধারণত লিরিক পোমের ক্ষেত্রে খুবই ইম্পর্টেন্ট, বা সংস যে লিরিক্স হয় সেখানে মেট্রিক্যাল প্যাটার্ন একটা রিদমে থাকা দরকার, নাহলে সুর আসবে না। ওকে, সো দিস ইজ দ্য মেন থিং, ফার্স্ট ইউ নিড টু স্টার্ট অফ উইথ দিস, দেন উইল আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্য ইউনো আদার টাইপস অফ পোয়েট্রি, টাইপস অফ ভার্স ইউল আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দেন, আনলেস এন্ড আনটিল ইউ আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দিস পার্ট, দ্য মিটার অ্যান্ড মেট্রিক্যাল প্যাটার্নস। ওকে, নাও ইফ ইউ লুক অ্যাট দ্য মেট্রিক্যাল প্যাটার্নস, দেয়ার আর দিস ফাইভ কাইন্ডস অফ ফিট। ওকে, লাইক আয়াম্বিক, ট্রোকেইক, অ্যানাপেস্টিক, ড্যাকটিলিক, স্পন্ডি অ্যান্ড পিরিক। সো আই উইল ডিসকাস দিস পার্ট, মিটার অ্যান্ড মেট্রিক্যাল প্যাটার্নস, ইন নেক্সট ভিডিও, ইন দ্য নেক্সট ভিডিও সাম টাইম লেটার ইফ আই গেট টাইম। সো দেয়ার ইজ ইউনো টাইপস অফ মিটার, stressed, unstressed syllable. So syllable is what constitutes meter, foot of a poem, then foot constitutes meter of a poem. Okay, it's like a chain, first syllable, then feet or foot, then you'll have this meter. So there is this type or the pattern of a meter, iambic, trochaic, anapestic, dactylic. So iambic is unstressed, stress. Okay, trochaic is the other way around, stress, unstressed. Anapestic is unstress, unstress, stress. Dactylic is the opposite of it. Spondy is too stressed, and pyrrhic, spondy is the too unstressed, I think, and pyrrhic is the too stressed. These are the main metrical pattern. Okay, first at least you need to have this concept of iambic and trochaic. These two are very common, so most of the questions would be from this part. Okay, anapestic, dactylic, spondy, pyrrhic, it's not very common, so it's considered as an exception of a meter. Now next, you need to understand the rhyme and types of rhyme. You all know it's a very common. Okay, exact rhyme, there are also types of rhyme, exact rhyme, internal rhyme, okay, slant rhyme, I rhyme, so masculine, feminine. Questions haven't been asked from this part till now, but you might expect because it's very common. And the next is types of rhyme scheme. So in sonnet, you might have heard the Shakespearean sonnet. Okay, so in sonnet we have this A B B A, or A B A B, B C B C, C D C D, E F E F, G G G G. okay, so there are three common rhyme scheme. Like we have Petrarchan, from Petrarchan we have this Spenserian, then from Spenserian then we have Shakespearean. Okay, so you need to understand the what is the pattern of the rhyme scheme of Petrarchan, the sonnets that Petrarch wrote, then Spenserian, then Shakespearean. Okay, so you might expect a poem from Shakespeare, then you might be asked what is the pattern of the rhyme. Okay, next is the types of verse. So if you understand types of metrical patterns, iambic, trochaic, then you will be able to understand types of verse. Okay, so like rhymed verse, a verse which is written in an iambic pentameter and it has rhyme at the end, then it will be a heroic couplet. Free verse means, free verse there is no rhyme and it might be in iambic pentameter. So a poem which is written in free verse, it might contain rhythm but might not contain rhyme. Okay, blank verse I have already discussed it, and the alexandrine. Okay, so these first three types of verse are very common. So you need to understand these types of verse if you understand already the meter and metrical patterns. Okay, now comes the types of stanza. I have written in this chronological way because first you have to understand meter, then rhyme, then types of scheme, rhyme scheme, then you'll be able to understand verse, then types of stanza. Okay, so you have to do it step by step. Types of stanza, we have Chaucerian stanza, the rhyme royal, that is also known as rhyme royal, Chaucerian stanza, Spenserian stanza, Ottava rhyma, Terza rhyma, heroic couplet. Okay, so till now in pubdate there are no questions from this part, but this is important. You might expect a stanza would be given and you might be asked to identify the kind of stanza it is, Terza rhyma or heroic couplet. Okay, now we have these types of poetry: dramatic poetry, dramatic monologue, narrative, epic, lyric. So epic like Mahakavya, lyric poem, elegy. In Old English there are some elegies, you have already studied I hope in Anglo-Saxon period. Okay, so sonnet to tumra porechho already, ballad, ode, pastoral, satire. Okay, concrete, doggerel, sestina. So this form, sestina, this is very modern types of form. Okay, in the past there was no sestina, and sestina is a rare poem. Okay, there was not many poems which are written in sestina form. Okay, it's same for doggerel or concrete, but these are very common: sonnet, elegy, lyric. Okay, so you need to distinguish each from other. You have to have a minimum distinct clear concept or a clear idea as to what is the elegy, what is the sonnet. Okay, so this is the thing, you need to do it. Okay, so this part, Volta, Canto, Enjambment, Caesura, Refrain. So a question from Caesura was asked in 2019. I didn't write that. Okay, I might make video on this part, what is Volta or Enjambment or Caesura. So this is a term we use for poetry. Okay, like Volta you'll find in sonnet, when a shift happens in the last stanza, in the Petrarchan sonnet, in the last stanza there is this shift of a theme, of a the idea the poet is presenting. In the last stanza there is this turn or sudden shift, that is known as Volta. So this term we use. So it's just a term. Okay, you need to understand this very simple concept behind this term, that is that. And canto is like a stanza. Okay, the Rape of the Lock, it's written in canto, so it's a past form of a poetry. You will find in many poems like canto. Enjambment, caesura. Okay, caesura is like a natural pause that we find in poetry. Okay, these are very little concept term that you need to know, that's that. And I will suggest some books. Okay, you might refer to that book for your study. Okay, now next I will start with the rhetoric part. So this I have written a lots of rhetoric or figure of speech here, but at least if you do simile, metaphor, synecdoche, metonymy, personification, irony, okay, then I guarantee you at least will get two or three questions. Okay, from this part itself, simile, metaphor, synecdoche, like I have already shown you that from 2017 to the 2019, questions from synecdoche, metonymy, metaphor, simile have already been asked. Okay, so if you have a clear idea as to what is simile, metaphor, then you'll not have much problem. Okay, and if you have time, then you can cover the rest of the figure of speech. There are lots of figure of speeches, so you don't have to do all that, but at least if you do those that I have written here, then I'm telling you guys, you will get common. Okay, you need to practice it. Okay, there are many poems, there are many examples, so only through example you'll be able to identify each from other. Otherwise like just studying theory, you won't be able to understand it. Okay, so now I'll mention some books. If you are willing to purchase books, so you can go for it, and I might give you the link of purchasing link in the description box below in this video. Okay, so you can purchase that book from there, and either you could buy this book. Okay, you might find a little bit of difficulty if you're just studying, you haven't studied earlier, then you might have some problems, but just stick to it. And you know, if you don't understand in reading that book, you can go to the website, search on it, and then you'll have so many websites, and you can visit that those websites, and you'll have, you know, better understanding bit by bit. Okay. And why I'm saying that you need to buy a book, and lots of people find it difficult that in book you'll have a whole lot of things into a consolidated form, you know, like a step by step course wise you'll find everything there. So starting randomly, it will be difficult for the beginner, because if you haven't studied already, okay, then you'll have some difficulty to study. Either you could, you know, study from this book, then if you have some problems, then you go to the websites, or you could, you know, like I have mentioned the parts you need to cover. So like you could study on your own on the internet, you know, searching simile, metaphor, or on YouTube you'll have lots of videos on that you could watch as well. Okay, so it's not big deal. You need to do it, you feel comfortable in whatever way you can study. And so these are the two books I can say. And so you can buy this book, Person Sterling. Lots of PubDate experience purchase this book, or also Rhetoric and Prosody by Prabhat Prakashan, you can purchase this book. So at least you just purchase one book, and then follow that, and then, you know, refer to some websites and some other materials. And this is what I say. Okay, now in the next video, if I have time, then I'll cover, you know, some literary terms, like I have mentioned in the PubDate preparation and GU English Entrance Test preparation, that there are some literary terms, literary movements, literary theory. You need to at least know those terms, what does that refer to, or the proponents of those terms or theory. Okay, so in the next video, stay tuned, I'll make videos on this, and also suggest some books on literary terms or movements, so that you can study on your own. So this is the thing, I hope that I have been able to explain things in simplest terms and clear way. And if you have any questions, you can ask me anytime in the comment section below or in my mail, contactenglish@gmail.com. I'll be able to help you, I'll be able to, you know, answer those questions. So guys, thank you for watching this video, and share this video to your friends who are in need of this video, who are aspirants of PubDate or any other college entrance test, because it's important that you do some basic level preparation rather than doing nothing. Just daydreaming won't help you get into presidency or Jadavpur. Okay, so thank you guys for watching this video.